Hi, my name is Piotr Galinski from Galton Studio, and in today's video I wanted to show you how to use a ToneNet to get the most out of your ToneX. Enjoy. Okay, first things first, you need to download an iKey Multimedia Product Manager from their website. Once you download and install it, you'll have your ToneX pedal. You need to register it using your serial number, that kind of stuff. Or if you're using only an application, you need to use a serial number from the software. And once you go to the software tab, there should be a ToneX. Okay, in my case, it's already downloaded, installed. You need to install, it should be here. Okay, something like that. You need to install it and authorize. Okay, next, you should go to the ToneNet, go to login, and log in into ToneNet with your iKey Multimedia account. Next up, you should create an account. In my case, I already have that done. So create an account, add a username, add some kind of like profile picture, and you're good to go. Okay, so let's open a ToneX application. In my case, it will be a standalone one. So right now, we have a basic preset or like tone model that iKey Multimedia gives us. I'm not really a huge fan of it, but you know what you can do. You can't really change it, you know, because it will always start with that black Angus. Okay, first thing that I am doing always, I'm always going to change everything. You can still do it here to around noon, at least parameters like presence, gain, bass, middle, treble, and that kind of stuff. Why? Because when you're changing any tone model, the EQ and other stuff, reverbs, will stay the same. Let's say I have something like that. No. Maxed gain, right? Maxed gain, maxed gain, maxed gain, maxed gain, maxed gain, that kind of stuff. And you know, when we will be downloading tone models from ToneNet, a lot of people, at least me, I am always like creating a profile or like tone model with everything at noon in mind, right? I'm not really doing it to have something like this because it makes no sense, right? Of course, you can use it, but you know, when you're creating tone model, everything should be around this area, right? Okay, so right now we're going to the ToneNet. Clicking here. And if you get any kind of error, try either reauthorizing your software in iKey Multimedia tab, something like that. Authorize, reauthorize. Because, you know, in my case, I had the same problem. I couldn't open ToneNet. And the only thing that helped me was unauthorize and reauthorize again. Yeah, I know that's weird, but it happened, unluckily. Okay, so right now we are in a ToneNet. Basically, it's like a big preset sharing platform that you can use to download any kind of models that other users created. And thing that I usually start with is go to most popular, right? Or at least I started at the very beginning, right? And this is like probably one of my favorites, actually. It's by Studio Rats, Matchless Independence. And right now, you can change anything. For example, I can add more gain. Yeah, sounds great, right? Okay, moving on. Let's go to the Dream 65 clean. Okay, as you can see, everything stayed the same. You know, the gain was maxed, so it stayed the same. Okay, let's go to the Bad Cut Club. Okay, another one. And let's say I really enjoy it. And I want to save it. And what you have to do, you need to go here. And right now we're downloading tone model to our library. And this is annoying, but you need to do it. Click here. And voila. we're in our tone model, we have bud, cut, clap, right? Simple, okay? But let's say I really enjoyed another one, for example, Tone Junkie. Okay, why not? Let's go to Tone Junkie. Oh, too much meat, for example, whatever, you know? Okay, I really, really like it. Or let's say I'm adding more reverb, you know? Whatever. Oh, I really, really like it. Okay, I'm downloading. And, oh. Okay, so it stayed the same. But if I would like to return to bud cut, oh. EQ stayed the same. And it's really annoying because, for example, some people made tone models in mind to have, like, you know, more gain or reverb or anything else. Or maybe you prefer less reverb or more mids. You have a Stratocaster and you prefer to have less presence. And thing that can help you are presets. Okay, so let's go to ToneNet once again and open my tone models. Why not? And here we go. Let's open my most popular one, Van Halen pack, Modern Van Halen. Okay. Okay, let's make noise get a little less annoying. I'll add a reverb. Of course, I'll download it, yes. And right now, here is my Modern Van Halen, right? And let's say I really enjoy it. What I can do? Click this one. And right now I can save my own presets from tone models that I downloaded from ToneNet. Okay, let's call it Van Halen 2107 because it's today. Okay? And that's it. Voila. And right now, when I go to the preset tab, I have my preset with my settings from that tone model that I downloaded in my preset tab. Okay? So let's say I had other presets recently. Or like... or anything else, right? This is great, because right now you're not forced to like change settings every single time, which is absolutely annoying, right? So you can, for example, download, I don't know, one or two or three models and create variations, right? For example, let's say I have my own, verse like pretty popular one, Much Less Dirt, right? And I want to create something that's like edge of breakup tone with a reverb, right? More gain, maybe. Let's say with a room reverb, right? I'll change to single coils. Okay, so I'm downloading it. Going back to presets, and I'll save it as like Much Less Edge, for example. Okay, and right now, there's like a Much Less Edge. in my presets with that, with the settings that I already made. Okay, let's head back to ToneNet once again, and let's say I want to find a JVM 410. Because I really enjoy this amp, maybe I have it at home, whatever. Okay, so right now we have something like this. Let's try it. Okay, let's download it. And right now, I'm not really a fan of this cabinet, right? So I can go to the cap section, go to, for example, custom IR, other IRs, but I really like this one, VIR. Oh. This is a greenback one. And what you can do, you can, for example, change the microphone, change the position. Yeah, I really like it. So right now, I can save it with that custom IR, right? Let's say JVM VIR. Okay. Great. And right now, I have it saved. So, why is it great? Basically, you are not forced to use a cabinet that a user enjoys, right? Because when I'm, for example, making my own tone models, I print the IR that I really like, or like I do profiles on my cabinet, which is like, which has like two V30s, and another cabinet that is Marshall. And you know, some people don't really like it. So what you can do, you can basically bypass what the user created and add your own IR, which gives unbelievable possibilities. You know, you can basically download any of the amplifiers and create your own presets. So this is like the best way for me to use a ToneNet, to download profiles of amps that you actually dig. And if there's something else, you need to tweak the parameters, add the reverbs, add other stuff, and maybe change IR and that kind of stuff. Okay, thanks a lot for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. And if you enjoy my tones, go to my ToneNet. And if you want more, you can download my paid packs. The link will be in the description. And see you in the next video. Bye.